Hello and welcome to another video for linmob.net, and today it's going to be about Manjaro again. And it's not going to be about the recently announced beta 2 release of Manjaro with Phosh, but instead I'm going to have a look at Plasma Mobile. And this is a dev image which was released on the 7th of November. So the fact I mistyped that just there is due to this device, which is also on Plasma Mobile right now, but that's post-market OS, and well, here I have a different pin and so on. Yeah, this is the BQ Aquarius X5. I made a video about how Phosh runs on that. Please check it out. Maybe I will make a video about it running Plasma Mobile later on. So, back to Manjaro. Let's hope it turns on again. Yeah, that's working just fine. And this is how it looks. And there are a couple apps pre-installed. I think that Qt QDBuzz Viewer is one that shouldn't appear here because it has no use for the user. And I'm not so sure about pSensor either. But aside from that, this is basically almost the same selection as we've seen on previous releases of Manjaro with Plasma Mobile. Let's just Boohoo and Nota and Index are Kirigami apps, are Maui Kit apps, and those are going to receive an update, but it isn't applied here yet. That's why I'm not showing them right now. The thing is, I tried to apply that update before recording this video, but it would break the install, and afterwards I wouldn't have phone functionality anymore. So that's something to try out on the next Manjaro Plasma Mobile release, I guess, because there's been a breaking update again, which is why I think you really can download this to have a look at Plasma Mobile, but you shouldn't expect to put all your data in and then use it, because it likely won't work unless you're massively more lucky than I am. Now, after this quite big caveat, let's just see whether I can connect this thing to Wi-Fi, because having connectivity is always nice and even necessary to try something decent with some of these apps. So here is my network, and that's that new keyboard. Well, it's not that new anymore, but yep, now this should work and we should be connected soon enough. We'll get a nice notification about that, and yeah, so that's that. So I've included a couple, excluded a couple apps. I won't apply these updates because, as I told you, they eventually break the system. Update couple days ago went fine, but today's update broke it for me earlier. So this is a fresh install. So this is Clocks. It has been a bit redone. It's a really nice, nicely designed Clocks app. And so let's get back to the home screen here by just pressing that button. By the way, there's a bug in PostmarketOS where these two buttons, the multitasking menu and the close this app menu, aren't there. And it made me realize that they aren't even necessary, because there's a gesture. Well, there are more, it's more than just one gesture, you know. There's the terminal app, which also has been retouched, because now there are these keyboard buttons in between those two menu options, you know, like this one with the actions and that one with settings in it. And that makes it so that you don't have that old issue that text would be hidden under those two buttons. And it's really nice and usable. You can you know, do a ton of stuff. You can tap complete, You can escape, which is handy when in Vim, or you can tab up to go back to previously executed commands. So, yeah, but I wanted to show you a gesture, and that is this one. You slide down, and then you can get out of this app by tapping the home button again. You can also use a gesture, swipe up, and then you have the multitasking menu, and in the multitasking menu you can close apps just like this. So that's really some improvement here, and I feel like this is much more smooth already than previous releases of Plasma Mobile. Now, we could have a look at Spacebar, which is the SMS app, but I haven't started any conversations here. I had demoed all that on the earlier release, but to show you, but yeah, it broke, so I had to redo it, and I didn't have the time to prepare because I've got something else on my schedule today. Now, Firefox is something that is going to be really important, I think, in the second part of this video, where we'll look into convergence. But even like this, it's fairly nice. Surprisingly, or to my surprise, the keyboard doesn't really show up here yet, even though it can be GTK aware now. So that's sad, and I think they should fix it. Also, Firefox mobile config is not installed here, which can be handy because it would make Firefox usable with Spotify. But then you would have to use an external keyboard to get that done. You know, like, for example, this one I have there. Now, I think I'll leave it at that because there haven't been all that many updates to all these apps here that are pre-installed. They basically mostly look the same. Still, I think KWeather may have changed. So let's have a brief look at that before I go to the second part of this video, which is going to be convergence. My laptop, yeah, see, here's a new menu, and you can set a theme, flat or dynamic. Because you already should know flat, I'm going with dynamic here. And let's add my current location. And yeah, it figured that out, so positioning is working. And this is really nice with those curves. Doesn't really show the dates here. It's foggy outside, and yeah, pretty nice. I think that's really a great weather app, and I have to say I like it a lot. And it's yeah, it's pretty great. It's 0.2, and it's already better than some apps are at there. 1.0 release, and yeah, so check that one out. You can also install it on some distributions like Arch Linux ARM from the AUR, because it's also the best weather app for Fosh, in my opinion. So yeah, let's go to convergence. See you soon. Hey, so I'm back. This is the PinePhone, and this is my HP Elite X3 laptop, which is quite a mouthful of a name, and I'm just going to connect it to this thing and then turn that on. I hope it will work. It's not the first try. Notice how this PinePhone screen just said internal keyboard deactivated, so that's interesting. And now there are graphical glitches here on the PinePhone screen, which you can hopefully see. It's a rather tough arrangement here. And yeah, there we are. So we've got to a Manjaro screen on the laptop, and now we've got this app drawer and all these apps. So if we click and hold, just like if you would touch and hold, you can now add widgets. And one of the most important widgets we would need right now is this one, and that is display settings. And let's try to get to the advanced display settings. Okay, so it sees this screen over there, so we know that, and I will just adjust to my reality here. And then I would just hit disabled here and then keep this one enabled because there's a rendering bug there anyway. And then apply, and now we've got basically the full menu system here on the laptop. I don't really know whether that setting persists, but if we were to use Firefox now, we could of course split the screen. What's happening there? Ah, oh my god, this is stressful. Briefly going to stop recording and see what happened there. Oh no, maybe I'm just too... Maybe I should just stay a bit more calm and not hit so many keys and it will turn on again. Yeah, there we are. So that's Firefox. And now it's just Firefox on one half of the screen. Great feature with this keyboard, and I don't know why that keyboard showed up there. Now that's a mess. And I'm going to try and restart and leave this in the video. Hey, so I'm going to try once more to connect these two devices here. And see what happens. And if it doesn't work, I'm going to show you this stuff on another distribution quite soon. So yeah, that's Plasma Mobile main screen. And great about this, I mean, it said that the keyboard would be deactivated, the on-screen keyboard, but it isn't. But you can use KRunner just like you can on a KDE desktop, so you can just choose your favorite app by typing a little. That's really a nice method of launching an app, and the fact that it has a hotkey is something I really prefer about the way it is in Fosh. Also, of course, we could add additional information by putting some widgets here and there, and I'm just going to start. Oh yeah, I think I clicked too often. No, we're back. Well, I'm going to do it this way. I'm going to start the terminal and try install something. And that would be Krita. Let's see if that works, because our install is slightly updated and this is Manjaro unstable, so it's moving fast. Krita is quite the download, so that's going to take a while too. But it seems to work. Let's try again to do split window. Yeah, works here. Now, I can also go back via Alt Tab. So if I go Alt Tab, I can find all these open apps. And it crashed. I guess that install also didn't go well, and now you can see the reports that something crashed. Don't blame it on Manjaro. This is really just a dev build, but that's all they deliver for Plasma Mobile currently. And well, maybe this video can help them with making another build. I don't know. Here's hoping. Would be really nice to see a stable Manjaro, more stable, upgradable Manjaro Plasma Mobile experience. Because if and when the keyboard of Manjaro Plasma supports GTK apps too, I think it's going to be a great choice, because then we are going to be able to, well, basically use a ton of more apps, and that's totally going to be great. And then, because I think Plasma Mobile with this gesture UI, let me just briefly show it to you here on this Postmarket OS BQ Aquarius X5. This is really nice, right? Having such a multitasking option, and having this app drawer that fills the entire screen even if the application's open, that's quite nice, and it's quite fluid. And yeah, if you could use any app available, any mobile cable Linux app available with it, and I think Manjaro has a ton of packages, so it would be well suited for that. That could really be something, and could replace Forsha as my daily driver, honestly. So let's hope that comes, that's going to happen. And yeah, thanks for watching. Have a great time, and make sure to check out my blog, which is at linmob.net, where I'm going to publish an article about this very thing soon, and also another one about convergence. It may take me another week to finish both of them, but I'm trying to get them out as soon as possible. So thanks for watching, have a great time, and see you soon. Now this looks weird. I will need to try again.